Hey folks, it's me, Antar1011, and I'm here to bring you a Gen 5 UU battle. My opponent today is dazzaMUFC10, who I met through Smogon, and he's using a team where all the Pokemon are from previous generations, but you know what? I mean, most Pokemon are from previous generations, so I'm like, okay, this is a redo of a Gen 4 team, I'm not sure at this point. Anyway, we both lead off with our elves, and he taunts me. I don't know why I wasn't predicting that. I think I was predicting him to go for the U-turn, actually, but that was really stupid of me. Anyway, I go ahead and switch at this point. He goes ahead and sets up his Stealth Rocks, and now he's going to go ahead and taunt me, thinking that I was going to Sleep Powder him, but no, I was going to go for the Power Whip, and look at how much damage that does. That's just so sexy. Anyway, U-turn is going to hit my Tangrowth pretty darn hard. But, you know, Tangrowth is pretty bulky defensively. Anyway, I predict the switch excellently and go for the Hidden Power Eyes. I'm like, ha, take that, Togekiss. Kiss. Oh, wait, that did nothing. Yeah. Hidden. I mean, I don't think I have any special attack investment in Kazulu. So it's not surprising that did nothing. Anyway, I'm going to go ahead and switch out my Golurk, predicting the T-Wave. Again, predict that quite excellently. So I'm doing okay with the predictions now, but it's just not doing me any good. He's gonna go ahead and air slash me, and it does a whole lot of damage, and he gets the flinch, and I'm like, man! I mean, it's Serene Grace, so of course he's gonna get the flinch. I think there's a 60% chance of him getting the flinch. Anyway, he predicts me to switch at this point, but I don't. I stay in, I go for the sub, and so now I'm behind a sub, I don't have to worry about getting flinched, and it's awesome. I really wish I had the Stone Edge on this set, but I don't, so instead I'm just gonna have to go for the Focus Punch, which is going to be regularly effective, and I'm just hoping it's going to do a lot of damage, considering the fact that it's the only attacking move that I have that actually can do damage to this guy. That's about half, a little less after leftovers. He's going to go ahead and do the air slash again. I'm going to go for the sub again. I survive with 21 HP, and I'm just hoping that there's going to be a case of min-max damage where I can actually take out his Togekiss with a Focus Punch, I'm sorry. But I'm not holding out too much hope. My substitute fades, go for the Focus Punch, and I'm like, come on, please kill, but he survives. And so now I do a really ballsy move. I think that he's going to predict my switch, go for the go for the T-Wave. Instead, he stays in, but his Air Slash misses, and I take him out, and that's totally awesome. So yeah, bit of hacks, really sorry about that. But I'm so glad I took out his Pokemon. Anyway, I'm going to go ahead and call back Crank at this point. Go ahead and send out my Uxie. He goes for the Zen Headbutt, and so Patrick's not going to take, not going to care about that at all. He's going to go ahead and taunt me. I can't remember whether I went for the, no, I will go for the Psychic here, because that's my only attacking move, but he was down to pretty low HP. Unfortunately, I'm not going to be able to set up my rocks, and he's going to send out his Shaymin. His Shaymin's going to go ahead and Toxic me, but I'm really not, worried here because I've got the Lumberry. I also have the Heal Bell, but, you know, I am taunted at this point, so it's not like I could actually use it. So I go ahead and call Patrick back at this point, and go ahead and send out Tux, my Empoleon, because I'm just trying to think how I can take this guy out. He's going to go ahead and Leech Seed me, which is great, because, you know, yeah, I'm going to take some residual damage, and he's going to get some residual recovery, but, you know, my Air Balloon isn't popped, and I think I'm going to be okay. His Seed Flare misses. Second bit of hacks there, really sorry about that. So he's draining my health, and I'm gonna go ahead and Ice Beam now that I'm faster, and just hope that it does some damage. Does not do nearly as much as I was hoping. Shaymin is a freaking beast, and it's totally ruining my team. Anyway, Ice Beam's not even gonna be a two-hit KO. I really should call back Tux at this point, but he does have, well, I resist the rocks, I could probably switch him again. But I don't think it's a good idea. And he's going to go ahead and take me out with a Hidden Power, probably Fire at this point, which tells me I probably shouldn't send in my Tangrowth. He's down to less than half, but I don't know. Anyway, I go ahead and send in Blake, and I'm thinking that this is going to force him to switch, and so I go for the Wild Charge. This is a Bandit Arcanine, and so when he doesn't switch, I'm like, oh man, are you serious? He's going to go ahead and Toxic me, and that was just an excellent prediction on his part that I, you know, was going to go for the stupid move predicting his switch, and it's times like this that I really wish I were Life Orbed rather than Bandit, but what can I do? Anyway, go ahead and send out Patrick again, just because I need to switch someone. And, you know, Patrick gets seated. I really wish that Heal Bell cured that as well, but it doesn't, of course. And Leech Seed is sapping my health. He's back up to almost half. He goes ahead and toxics me, and I think I go for the Heal Bell here, which is great because I've cured two Pokemon of poison, so that's excellent. I'm down to about a half HP, and he's just gaining back all of it with that Leech Seed, so this is really no good. I call Patrick back, and I go ahead and send out my Hugabug, my Galvantula. He's going to go ahead and go for the Seed Flare here, and I'm thinking, ah, I can take that. And indeed, I take it okay, but he gets the special defense drop, and I'm like, no, seriously? So now I'm going to really hope that this Bug Buzz KOs, because if it doesn't, I just don't know how I'm going to deal with the Shaman. He survived with just a little bit of HP. Had I been running Modest instead of Timid, I would have killed it, but I guess Modest is to outspeed Zoroark, which practically no one uses anyway. So maybe I'll rebreed, I don't know. Anyway, go ahead and send out Blake, my Arcanine, and I'm thinking, okay, I think I can take him out with an Extreme Speed, but I don't want to risk it, I don't want the recoil, so I'm going to go ahead and go for the close combat and take out his Shaman. So I'm like, yes, Shaman is down, and he goes ahead and sends out Flygon here, which I'm expecting to be a Scarf Flygon, and so I'm going to go ahead and switch out into my Clank, basically as Death Fodder, just because I want to see what he's going to lock himself into. He goes for the Stone Edge, which, you know, had Clank had any more HP than that, would have probably survived. So anyway, I go ahead and send out Kudzulu here, because I think it can take any of these hits. And he goes ahead and withdraws Flygon, and goes ahead and sends out Suicune. I think I go for the Sleep Powder, but it misses! And I'm like, no! Come on! Did you seriously? Hax Gods, why? So he goes for the Ice Beam here, but again, as I said before, I'm specially defensive. I take that hit, and survive with 167 HP. I go ahead and put him to sleep, and so now I'm like, yes, now as long as he stays asleep, I can take him out. I go for the Power Whip here, and, you know, it's gonna do a whole lot of damage because I've invested, I'm actually max attack, not plus attack nature, but max attack investment. Suicune wakes up, and I'm like, what?! What are you doing to me? One turn of sleep? Are you serious? Why, God, why? So I go ahead and Power Whip here. And I take out a Suicune. So thank God for that. But Kudzulu is down to 78 HP. Luckily, I do have the Regenerator ability. Gonna go ahead and call Kudzulu back, really hoping that he was going to go for the Fire Blast, since I'm immune to it. But he goes for the Earth Power, and I'm like, damn it. So Blake is taken out. Really should have sent in Patrick as a scout, but I just didn't. So, and also Patrick, you know, I thought had the best chance of KOing. Taken out by a Flamethrower at that low HP. My Uxie is there actually to take on Nidokings, but, you know, can't do it at that low HP. Flamethrower is going to take out Kudzulu, and that is the game. So, great game, dazzaMUFC10. Pokebox5 subscribers, comment and rate, and check out my channel if you want. So long, folks.